Greece is under lockdown. Human activities have stopped. No boats in proximity. But on the bottom of the sea, a really dynamic and productive city doesn't seem to care about what's going on land and works at full speed. Your journey inside this incredible underwater world is about to begin. You are going to see how seasons bring about changes in this city and how its inhabitants follow these dynamics. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Posidonia Oceanica. It is a cold and windy winter day. Waves are putting plankton in suspension in the water, and the Posidonia is dancing by the rhythm of the sea. Despite the strong current, this plant remains well anchored to the substratum. The foundation of this city are called mats. Roots, rhizomes and dead leaves at the base of the plant trap and compact the sediment, creating this structure, which allows the plant to be steadily fixed to the substratum. Unfortunately, sometimes the sea gets the upper hand and then roots part of the city. But why is Posidonia considered the treasure of the Mediterranean Sea? What is this city hiding? We start flying over the plant looking for answers. It's impressive how big the expanses of this species can be, with several square kilometers recovered. But smaller areas are precious too. On sandy bottom, up to 40 meters deep, the Posidonia finds the perfect condition for its settlement. As a plant, light represents one of its main limiting factors, thus requiring very limpid water to carry out its functions. In fact, this plant produces a great amount of oxygen and captures carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, performing a key role in regulating the ecological equilibrium of the sea. We are looking through the leaves, when we suddenly notice something yellow sliding very slowly. A moray is hiding inside the Posidonia, waiting for a tasty meal, and we are probably making its camouflage ineffective. Maybe it is better to leave this fish alone. No one likes when someone stares at you while you try to eat. This species is one of the many inhabitants who hangs out in this city. Over the predator, an aggregation of Mediterranean damselfish is floating peacefully. They really appreciate the green meadow, because in case of danger, they can rapidly find a good shelter. Despite everything, it's very difficult to examine this city from above. We decide to change strategy. We move to the suburbs, to observe the city from another perspective and to better understand its stratification. echinoderms. Mollusks, crustaceans, and polychaetes populate the streets of the slums, consisting of roots and rhizomes. Each species contributes to the wellness of this community. Detritivore organisms, like the sea cucumber, keep the roads clean. Sea urchins, like the Paracentrotus lividus, maintain the public green area directly by eating the leaves, and subsequently controlling the expansion of the city. While gastropods and isopods feed on epiphyte communities that grow on leaves, preventing light from reaching them and obstructing gas exchanges. Polychaetes offer an underground service, digging tunnels and stabilizing the substratum. Infiltrator animals provide a better quality of the surrounding water. All these organisms cooperate to keep this habitat healthy and work to make it grow lush. But it's not that easy to maintain such delicate equilibrium. And when it changes, the results can be catastrophic. It's the case of an overabundance of Posidonia predators. The grazing activity of many sea urchins can destroy an entire city, leaving behind empty areas called barren grounds. Fortunately, the variety of species also attracts predators of higher level in the trophic chain. Rainbow wrasses and sea bream live in the upper part of the city and come to the meadow to feed on sea urchins, controlling their expansion, but that's not the only reason. The Posidonia offers protection to juveniles of many species, allowing them to easily hide from bigger predators. Once grown up, they will leave the safety of this city and start a new life in the open sea. In winter, we can appreciate just a small fraction of the great biodiversity that populates the Posidonia oceanica, endemic species of the Mediterranean basin. But the contribution of this plant to the sustenance of the marine ecosystem is always precious. Posidonia meadows act like barriers, breaking the strength of coastal storms and preventing shore erosion. In this season, it's easy to find huge masses of dead leaves on the foreshore, accumulated by the waves on the beach. Even if these piles, called banquettes, seem to be just wastes of the sea, they are very important for the protection of the litoral and offer food and shelter to many species, such as insects and crustaceans. Observing all the species' richness, all the benefits this seagrass brings to the marine environment and more, we immediately realize that the fortune we were looking for was in front of us from the very start. This habitat, thanks to its ecosystem services and its biodiversity, truly represents the treasure of the Mediterranean Sea. But the journey is not over yet. Follow us, season after season, to the discovery of this underwater city. Many other surprises await, and we will be here, all set to reveal their secrets to you.